Hello and welcome to Legislative Report. I'm State Representative Mario Scavello of the 176th District in Monroe County. As a supporter of music education, I would like to present a special program today. In April, two schools from our area visited Harrisburg to perform their choral programs in the Capitol Building. Fourth graders from Notre Dame presented a program of patriotic music, and we'll hear from them later in the program. But first, please sit back and enjoy the sounds of the fourth grade chorus from Monsignor McHugh and Cresco as they performed in the Capitol Rotunda.
Thank you.
You've been listening to the performance of the Monsignor McHugh fourth grade chorus. Stay tuned for a concert presented by the Notre Dame. Legislative Report will return in a moment.
Did you know that there are 6 ornate bronze chandeliers hanging in the House Chamber? The 4 large chandeliers are estimated to weigh 3 tons each. Yet these iron and brass fixtures, painted in 18-karat gold, manage to dangle effortlessly. It takes 168 light bulbs to light the large chandeliers and 84 light bulbs on each of the smaller chandeliers. As you can imagine, changing the light bulbs when they burn out is far from easy. Workers must build scaffolding in order to reach their 1,450 light bulbs. Today, special long-life, low-wattage energy-saving bulbs are used to lessen the amount of times that the light bulbs will need to be replaced. Now you know.
That Violet Oakley was the first female artist to receive a large commission for artwork done in a United States Capitol building? In 1902, Joseph Houston, designer and architect for the 3rd Harrisburg Capitol building, commissioned Violet Oakley to paint murals for the governor's reception room. He believed that Oakley's contribution would add interest to the building and act as an encouragement of women of the state. Prior to beginning her work for the Capitol, Oakley set out to England to conduct research for her murals. Upon return, she decided to center her artwork on William Penn and the founding of Pennsylvania. Oakley made sure that Penn's ideals of justice and peace could be seen throughout her work. In 1906, she completed 13 murals titled The Founding of the State of Liberty Spiritual and was placed in sequential order around the governor's reception room. These murals were some of the first to be installed in the Capitol. When Edwin Austin Abbey, another artist for the Capitol, died in 1911, Oakley was offered another opportunity to create murals for the unfinished Senate and Supreme Court chambers. Her work on the Senate murals, including International Understanding, was completed by 1919. Oakley then completed the Supreme Court murals, including the Divine Law, by 1927. Oakley is said to be the principal artist for the Capitol, with a total of 43 murals on display. She remains one of the greatest muralists in the United States. Now you know.
Welcome back. I'm State Representative Mario Scavello. For the second half of the program, you'll hear from the Notre Dame fourth grade chorus, who performed in the East Wing of the Capitol. I know you'll enjoy their concert.
Good afternoon. We are the fourth grade class of the Notre Dame Elementary School in East Strasburg. We are very excited to be here today to perform for you. We will be singing some patriotic songs that you know and some you may not know. Please stand as we sing our national anthem. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
It was a great joy to see these children perform and to hear the sounds of their voices in our beautiful Capitol building. That's all the time we have for today's program. I'm State Representative Mario Scavello. If you need any assistance on any state-related matter, please feel free to contact me at my local office. The address and phone number will be shown in a moment. Thanks for watching, and please join me next time for another edition of Legislative Report.